So we're switching gears and leave for a minute, or maybe five, the applied engineering area. Our professor that pursued a more fundamental approach to engineering. Shining star in this field is the mathematician Raymond Mindlin. And Raymond Mindlin is Professor Kaiser's most favorite historical Columbia figure, and he will tell you why.
Raymond Mindlin was a civil engineer who pioneered many theoretical advances in many areas of engineering mechanics, theories which are widely used to this day. He is generally considered to be one of the premier elasticians of his time. For his doctoral research here at Columbia University, Mindlin solved the fundamental problem in theoretical elasticity involving a subsurface concentrated force in a three-dimensional elastic half space. This problem is now known as the Mindlin problem and is widely used as the basis of numerous elasticity solutions, especially in the field of geomechanics. His groundbreaking contributions in structural mechanics accounted for the shear deformation and the bending of thick plates, an important formulation now known as Mindlin plate theory. During the Second World War, Mindlin joined the war effort, leading the development of the proximity fuse, which required packaging radios with glass vacuum tubes into artillery shells. This detonator was used widely during the Second World War, leading President Harry Truman to award him the Presidential Medal of Merit for this technological feat. After the war, Mindlin's work with Bell Telephone Laboratories led to his addressing new challenges emerging in communications, such as predicting the vibration characteristics of single crystal plates for quartz resonators and predicting the wave dispersion relations for both optical and acoustic branches based upon generalized continuum concepts. For his many advances, Professor Mindlin was elected to the National Academy of Engineering, the National Academy of Sciences, the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, and near the end of his career, he was recognized by President Jimmy Carter with the National Medal of Science. In 2009, the American Society of Civil Engineers created a medal in honor of Professor Mindlin. The Mindlin Medal recognizes outstanding research contributions by individuals applied to solid mechanics. At Columbia today, many engineers still work on the fundamental foundation of engineering, where the boundaries of science and engineering begin to blur. Nanoscience and nanoengineering is one such area, and our next speaker, Professor Venkat Raman, will tell you more about it.
So today, scientists and engineers at Columbia University are working together to create electronic circuits at the nanometer scale using novel materials. This drive for miniaturization of electronic components has come a long way since the first invention of the transistor at Bell Labs in 1946. This was followed by the creation of an integrated circuit at Texas Instruments in 1959. And since then, we've come a long way. Intel, in 2010, created a processor, that's what's shown in the background here, that had over a billion transistors all packed into a chip. Today, Intel is able to create a transistor that's only 14 nanometers across. This is a scaling of a factor of a million down from the original one. This is all a great achievement, but what we are trying to do is go much beyond this. As an example, my group created a single molecule switch where the length scale was only a nanometer, and we could toggle between an off and an on state using a mechanical trigger. So the research in my lab focuses on understanding how these circuits at the nanometer scale work, and in order to do this work, we develop our own instruments to do the measurements, but we also collaborate with chemists and engineers in order to build instruments as well as to develop and design new chemistries to make molecules that have interesting function. As an example, we created a single molecule potentiometer or POT, as electrical engineers might call it, is a variable resistor and it goes beyond just simply making a circuit that goes between two states. So the work in my group has My group has taken on many challenges in this area of single molecule electronics, but driven by my incredibly talented CS graduate students, we have gone a long way. We are measuring more important properties, not just currents in these circuits. For example, we can measure how much force is required to break a single bond in the circuit, or we are trying to control how much current we can drive through the circuit using light. These are some examples of the new sciences that we are bringing to this field. And all the work that we do is basic understanding, and it has implications over a wide variety of areas, including solar energy and biophysical processes such as photosynthesis. Thank you.